But I still want to come back in and, you know, as I said, do this, see just how it's moving. So, because you can see how much also that he really likes that. And even in here, you can see he's going to really just love this area being worked. Is that right? Can you sense that incredible joy for this area? No, he can't talk right now. Yeah.
I actually do like that area. That's for my plantar fasciitis.
Yeah. So he likes it when it's in, you know, it's kind of like with good pain. It's like, it's like I really like it. It hurts so good. You know? Yeah. He's knowing that that's where it needs to have it done. Yeah. You know, like Eskimos have like 25 words for snow and English has like 3, you know? We need more words for pain because there's good, like there's definitely good pain and there's bad pains and there's, you know, and as long as you're finding and getting rid of it, you get like, when you receive a lot of good massage, you start to want, you just want somebody to relieve your tension and you know how good that feels afterward. So you want them to do that, you know? It's not like, ooh, I love the pain. I just love the release, you know? And the pain's gonna be part of that. So that's just, so here I'm just giving him his other toes a bit of a work, you know, just even feeling like the band below, the band on top, and just again, trying to keep it within what he can handle. So letting him breathe a bit. Process. Is that going to your head, Dave? Yeah. We just gotta let his breath catch up. You know, like a dizziness, you could get a little bit lightheaded.
Yeah,
but if you just deep breathe, it'll all. Or you come in and you
just
massage.
Come in and just do some more work into the head.
Yeah, and usually use a towel or something or cloth just so you don't pick up that energy that's stirred up. Yeah. So, because I'm trying to get quite a lot done in a short period of time, so I'm sort of pushing him to his maximum here, even when I'm talking to you guys. Oh yeah, but you know, you can only handle so much even when you appreciate it. And I'm finding that there's just something like really intense going on back here, which is all coming into here. This is where I like this tool as well, because the metal is quite strong. You can really get into the foot quite deeply here. And I'm gonna ease off as I see him tightening against me. How's that, Dave?
Yes,
good aim. Good aim, okay. So we can even just move it around, keep that same level of pressure, and just see how it's going with it. Oh, nice. That's music to my ears, because I know it's just it's playing a human, you know, an instrument. But I just know it's things are going back into place. So it's just a nice, you know, you're loosening the soft tissue. You're achieving something, yeah, because all that soft tissue work of loosening muscles and energy and then all of a sudden, even the structure of the body, which is the skeletal system, moves into place too. It's just wonderful. So here I'm just trying to, because this toe is so messed up, like it's so pulled forward, that. But even just stretching it's intense for him.
Yes. You know?
And then moving side to side. So, you know, you think, oh, this doesn't look, on another person, this wouldn't hurt at all, you know? But because of that, normal, I met him one day. I couldn't believe it. I was like, I fucking heard about normal. And then I met him. I was trying to figure out where that word came from, whether it's to do with the Normans. Or, you know, the word normal only appeared in the 1850s.
Really?
Before that, it wasn't part of the English language. Yeah.
That's
interesting.
Really,
yeah, it's a funny word. It really is.
Really? Like, there's
yeah, any of us normal in here? Even the average is like, you know, average what? You know, like, average tension.
I can confirm there's no normal people in here.
Yeah, okay, good.
I still meet with them.
Okay, good.
No normal people.
They kind of irritate me, normal people. Yeah, good.
Normies? They call them the normies.
Oh, yeah.
The normies, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. It's so what I like to use is like optimal function of joints or optimal optimal release of tension, you know? Optimal tension is not. Right? So optimal is better. You know, because otherwise people also, you know, it's like I don't know, when they ask that question, is this normal, is it, no, but is it normal to be tight? Oh, well, most people are, so I guess that is normal. You know what I mean? It's just, but it is a very, not such a useful word. But optimal is, because then you're saying to a person, well, this isn't optimal, right? Okay, oh, it's not optimal. Okay, let's, you know, you could be a lot better. You know, things like that. It's not about who comparing you to anybody else. It's about you could be more yourself. Right.
The phrase suboptimal a lot
on some
surveys.
Okay, yeah.
Suboptimal.
Suboptimal means pretty shitty.
Yeah, shit.
Yeah.
But it's a fine example.
Yeah. But we could say his, you know, his tension levels are suboptimal, you know? Which is what we is because the person might go, well, is this, because really what they're wondering is when they're saying, is this normal, is this how it should be or whatever. Well, whatever should be, but it's not at the best. it could be a lot better, and that's what we're trying. It could be better, and that's what we're going to try and help you with if you want us to, right?
So you could say, so is this normal? You could say, well, normal is mediocre.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right. But it's, yeah, if normal, suboptimal. Because even mediocre is like, how do we, you know? But yeah, because his feet are probably slightly less than mediocre, you know. In terms of like, if I just graded his feet in terms of other people. But we need to let him know that this is fucked, you know? And he could be a lot better than that, you know? In case he doesn't know. Dave, he knows that his feet are messed up, you know? He just hasn't had somebody with enough love and care for him to do the work for him.
So it's irregular. When the person's available to massage me, they're generally available, but then they're not. So it's kind of a. You actually, here's Steve. I think you might know Christian, who was on Christian on the training course. I think he was.
Christian.
He did reflexology.
Was it on your Devon course? Was one of another guy, quite a young guy, called Christian.
I can't remember his name. I do remember a younger guy on that.
Yeah, but I think he was at one point. So he lives not far from me. He lives out in Y. So he often gives me treatment.
So it's really interesting where Dave was saying he's getting that sort of calloused skin. It's really near where he's extremely tight. Too. Like it's all kind of like really distorted through here in suboptimal. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But see, even here where before he was objecting, now you can see how much he's enjoying it. He's almost at that point where he's saying thank you very much.
Friend.
He's not quite at that point of saying thank you very much, but he's, you know, he's almost at that point of chewing his arm, you know, just, yeah, chewing his arm off and you know, just getting in here. We're again just seeing whether he can actually handle this. Yeah.
This looks a lot worse than his hand.
It's okay to cry, it's okay to scream, and it's okay to just say fuck really loud. Has anyone accidentally kicked you while you're doing this?
Yeah.
Yeah,
I'm not 100% sure it was accidental.
Yeah.
Maybe instinctual? Yeah.
I have, like, more than
they have to watch their groins.
Yeah, here, go in therapy, they can plan.
And I think my wife was working on me the other day. I think the kids were sidetracking her. She worked, whacked her in the head. I mean, it wasn't like I intended to. It was just an instinctual thing, you know? Yeah. So just getting into this top area here where he's like, you could see that one. So then I can also work with it like this.
Is this like big toe belly band and delta band?
Yeah, he's tight in like all, like delta band, big toe belly, big toe sacrum. I think like almost every band, he's tight in because the upper little toe band, the outer little, they're all tight. The whole thing is just a disaster. To be polite, because I don't like to swear. Oh, that was so good. Did you hear that on that? Yeah, that was amazing. I get music to my ears,
And he was singing.
Yeah, he was singing. He was gonna sing along with me there for a minute, Yeah. a bit of thrash or something, whatever. He could be yodeling, I've heard all sorts of singing. As long as they're comfortable, that's the main thing. What's that?
He looks comfortable.
He looks comfortable.
With getting so much caressing.
Yeah, well, that's it.
And then take good spoiling.
Now I'm just going to stretch that foot a little bit. Okay, and I'm going to ease it off. That's just stretching it, That's because he's so tight across. This is one area where I do like to use a little bit of cream. Dave, did you bring any massage oil or cream or anything?
Some oil.
I'll just get some water and then I'll show you how. This is the main area that I love. How are you feeling, Dave? Too much in your head or it's okay?
What do you mean? What do you want to say?